It's rumored to have been 10 years since the Apple Car project began, with analysts anticipating its release in 2028. But according to a recent internal announcement, Apple's canceled the project after investing billions of dollars and hiring hundreds of employees. So why is Apple giving up? Well, the first reason has to do with technological limitations. Apple originally had quite lofty goals for their car. They wanted it to have at least level 5 full self-driving with no steering wheel or pedals. And instead of a touchscreen for navigation, they wanted to use voice control with Siri. But these targets proved difficult to achieve, as they tried developing self-driving technology and realized it would take far longer to perfect than anticipated. Plus, centering the car's operating system around Siri was a big risk, since the assistant still struggles with simple requests on existing Apple products. So eventually they scaled back their goals for Apple Car, opting instead for level 2 self-driving, which is essentially adaptive cruise control with lane keeping, and creating a more traditional interior with a steering wheel, pedals, and touchscreen for navigation. But this created an issue. As the Apple Car was stripped of advanced features, it lost its unique selling points, something Apple requires of any major new product. With the Mac, it was the mouse and graphical user interface. With iPhone, it was the multi-touch display and simple operating system. With iPad, it was the low price, compact size, and advanced app ecosystem. With Vision Pro, it was the high-resolution displays with industry-leading hand and eye tracking. All these features set Apple's products apart and convinced customers to pay their often premium price. But the Apple Car didn't really have a unique set of features, and the existence of CarPlay made matters worse. Apple typically makes their operating systems and software a major part of their product's differentiation, but CarPlay already delivers a seamless Apple experience in a wide variety of vehicles, which, again, makes it difficult for the Apple Car to stand out. The last issue was price. Apple expected their car to cost around $100,000, which is more than double the average new car price of $48,000. This is not only prohibitively expensive, but it didn't even deliver the usual profit margin Apple enjoys on their other products. And if they couldn't create a unique breakthrough feature for Apple Car, customers would likely just buy a more affordable EV with CarPlay. Now, many are saying this is the end of Apple Car, but others aren't so sure. Apple's shifted their focus from a car to generative AI technology, which powers services like ChatGPT. And this could be a sign that Apple believes advanced AI is needed to make things like self-driving cars possible. In fact, Tim Cook himself said autonomous driving was the mother of all AI projects. And imagine how much Siri would improve when powered by artificial intelligence. It could be that Apple does eventually make a car, but only when AI technology can deliver the breakthrough features needed to make the product successful. This is Greg with Apple Explained, and if you want to learn how I make videos like these, let me know by tapping the link in the comments.